Hey guys, this is the Apple HomePod, the new smart speaker that's all about audio and less about smarts. To set it up is as easy as putting your iPhone near the speaker. Then you press a few on-screen confirmation buttons. Once that's done, it's linked to your account, and as long as you use Apple Music, away you go.
Hi, I'm Siri. Welcome to HomePod.
Now, perhaps the most interesting part from a design perspective is the glossy control panel on the top. It has this glowing orb that appears whenever you use the hot word, Hey Siri, and also has volume up and down controls which light up when you need them. It's touch sensitive too, so you can press and hold the middle to activate Siri that way. Sound-wise, it has easily the best sound quality we've heard from any smart speaker of any kind. It's nice, bassy, but clear and doesn't distort at loud volumes. And that's thanks to the 4-inch up-firing woofer and 7 tweeters. This fills any space with one big giant sweet spot. On the smart side, powered by the A8 processor, Siri still has some way to go before it's as useful as Alexa. HomeKit doesn't quite have as wide a smart home support at the moment, and the voice sounds a little less natural than Alexa too.
It's currently partly cloudy and 3 degrees in Ascot. Expect cloudy skies and snow starting tonight. Temperatures are heading down from 3 degrees this morning to 0 tonight.
In Sunning Hill, it's 2 degrees with partly sunny skies. Today, you can expect lots of clouds, with a high of 3 degrees and a low of minus 3 degrees.
What's more, there's no support for radio stations other than Beats, and you can only stream music through Apple Music. You can read our full review on Pocket-lint.com, the link is below, but for now, at £319, it's a limited, fairly expensive smart speaker that sounds brilliant, but just isn't that smart or versatile. I'll see you again soon.